Good afternoon, Team Earle. It's been a while since I've last addressed you all in regard to the COVID-19 pandemic. In light of some recent developments, I wanted you all to hear from me some important news. As you know, across the nation, the number of positive COVID cases, transmission rate, and number of hospitalizations has steadily risen, and all signs point to this being the beginning of a second wave. I have decided the best course of action is for Naval Weapons Station Earle to return to Health Protection Condition Charlie. Across the country, 32 of 50 installations will be in HPCON Charlie this week to include all installations under Commander Navy Region Mid-Atlantic. This is not a decision I nor any other commander makes lightly, and it is doubly disappointing to revert back to a more restrictive posture as we enter into the holiday season. I want to stress that the sailors and civilians of Naval Weapons Station Earle have been doing a superb job in terms of stemming the spread of the virus. You have all taken this seriously. You have all been careful, and you have all been doing your part. But I don't want you to think that just because we've been successful at stemming the spread of the virus, that we've had no cases on this installation. Up until now, those cases were few and far between. In the last 2 weeks, we have seen a definite uptick in cases throughout the various commands on board the installation. All have been identified, isolated, and contact tracing has been completed. If you were not aware of a possible positive case, consider yourself lucky. That means that you have not been in contact with an infected individual and were not part of the contact tracing chain. Additionally, it is critical that we are able to protect individual privacy under the HIPAA law. As we work through this process, to date, contact tracing has shown that none of the positive COVID cases were contracted on the installation. The sad reality is that despite our efforts inside our installation to mitigate the spread of COVID, the rise in positive cases in Monmouth County, the state of New Jersey, and throughout the country at large create too great a threat to the people and mission of this base. Just like any threat to our installation, I must take the necessary steps to protect you all and preserve our mission. Aside from the restrictions related to HPCON Charlie, which I will highlight in a minute, we must all continue to practice the things we know will keep each other safe, which is limiting the number of people we have close contact with, maintaining social distance of 6 or more feet, washing your hands regularly for 20 seconds or more, and wearing face masks. The restrictions under HPCON Charlie will include the following. Military travel as a whole is restricted to less than 50 miles from the installation. Take note that the 50 miles or less does not start from your home off base, but from Naval Weapons Station Earle. Special consideration will be made on a case-by-case basis, and there is some additional information that is being provided to service members through their chain of command. Civilian employees are highly encouraged to adhere to the 50-mile radius as well, and will be subject to being placed in a 14-day restriction of movement, known as ROM, status, immediately following any travel outside of 50 miles. Military service members must limit local travel from their domicile to retrieve or take care of essential items only. That means going to and from work, dropping or picking up your children at school, visits to the grocery store, medical appointments, picking up meals or medicine, and the like. Any travel for other than essential items is a violation of a lawful naval order issued from our superiors. Leave for sailors will still be an option provided to all departments. I know each department is working hard to ensure all those who desire leave are granted it. Upon returning from leave, you will be expected to ROM for 14 days immediately upon return, so plan ahead. Civilians taking leave outside the local 50-mile radius area will also be required to ROM for 14 days upon return. Now for some really good news. Naval Weapons Station Earle has been approved to remain decoupled. What that means is we will not have to shut down critical quality of life services that are provided on base for you. The main side gym will reopen after the Thanksgiving holiday for active duty and activated reservists working and residing on the installation, in addition to the firefighters. The waterside gym will remain open for active duty and activated reservists working and residing on the installation along with the firefighters. The hobby shop will remain open and available for active duty, activated reservists, and federal employees working and residing on the installation. Fishing at the pier remains open to active duty, activated reservists, and federal employees working and residing on the installation. Hunting remains open to active duty, activated reservists, and federal employees working and residing on the installation. Morale, welfare, and recreation events will be reassessed and realigned to comply with all CDC COVID mitigations, along with encompassing the gathering limitation of 10 personnel or less, to include MWR staff. The MWR team will continue to be out in front through creative, fun, and engaging activities via virtual, takeout, or whatever creative means they come up with. I highly encourage you all to follow the NWS Earle MWR Facebook page and subscribe to their weekly services newsletter, The Scuttlebutt, to learn more about how MWR will continue to serve you during HPCON Charlie, the child and youth programs, including the Child Development Center and Youth Center, that are limited to active duty military mission essential personnel only. For a full list of service cancellations and changes, please refer to the latest graphic, which was posted here to our social media sites, as well as on our website. I know this news comes as a huge disappointment to all, and my wife and I share that disappointment as well. This certainly wasn't where I wanted or thought we would be heading into the holiday season. Regardless, we will continue to press on and do what we need to do to protect each other and the mission capabilities of Naval Weapons Station Earle. I want to take this time to talk about another important topic, one that becomes all too real during the holiday season, and especially now under our new restrictions. Suicide is a real threat to our force. Depression, anxiety, and substance abuse are all signs of contributing factors to suicide. It's up to each and every one of us to understand the signs, to look for them in our friends, family, and coworkers, and to ensure our shipmates and civilian associates are getting the help they need. There is no shame in seeking help, nor should there be any hesitance to seek or provide help. If you are struggling with depression, anxiety, substance abuse, or if something just doesn't feel right, I urge you to reach out to someone for help before it's too late. There are a number of services available to you: Chaplain, Fleet and Family Service Center, or the number of services available through the Military One Source. You can also call the National Suicide Prevention Hotline at 1-800-273-8255. Again, that's 1-800-273-TALK. If you're having thoughts of suicide, reach out immediately to get the help you need. Remember, there is nothing you are dealing with that is so severe as to take such permanent and drastic action. Also remember that you are an important member of our team, and we will always be right there with you, fighting for you. I want to wish you all a very happy holiday season. Do what you can to stay in touch with loved ones. Don't neglect that phone call to a parent, friend, or shipmate. It may be just the thing that helps you or them make it through the day. Continue to take necessary steps to protect yourselves and each other from the dangers of COVID. This is an endurance race, not a sprint. So prepare yourself to go the distance. We are all in this together, and together we will get through it. Thank you.